we're looking at marine protected areas in a new way. Marine protected areas are now tools that are being used around the world to help protect oceans. And we're putting together a new program, which is now called our Marine Protected Area Citizen Science Cruise. So today's program really focused on the marine protected area, which is located right here off the Newport Beach. The area stretches from one end of Crystal Cove State Park all the way to the Newport Jetty. There was a new law that was passed on January 1st, and this is our opportunity to involve students in the implementation of that new law.
So we're going to turn you guys into the scientists that are going to help us better manage our offshore resources.
So as Harry mentioned, you're going out on the Marine Protected Area Citizen Science Cruise. It's important for students to get a chance to see what it's like to be a scientist. So in the classroom, they learn about science, they might do some activities in the classroom, or they might read something in a textbook, but this program allows them to get out onto the water and out into the field and actually be the scientists. They're the ones who are collecting the data, they're the ones who are analyzing the data. It's actually going to be used by scientists who are studying the marine protected areas in the region. And scientists can't be out on the water every single day collecting the data, so the more students we have going out there collecting data, that helps the scientists better understand the ecosystem. We had designed the program to allow us to be there to make sure the students are safe and we can teach them how to use the equipment safely, but the goal was for us to then be able to step back and let the students actually do the investigations. Once we get offshore to the marine protected area, we deploy our plankton nets.
That one in!
So they collect the plankton sample. We anchor at a location where the students get a chance to collect the rest of the data. But this program is really great because we have students going out on a sport fishing vessel using fishing rods, but they're not catching fish, they're taking pictures of fish. And the Newport Landing staff are always so helpful in identifying them.
Oh, look at that. Look at the sea star. Look at that, look at the anemone. Look at this guy's an expert diving right now.
And by studying fish populations in kelp forests in a healthy reserve, we can start to understand whether or not the reserve is actually working.
Go ahead and do it again, move it around some more.
When we look at the ocean, we can't really tell the chemistry and what's happening inside of it. Our students get to use special equipment. In this case, they're using a Van Doren bottle. They lower the bottles down to different depths.
Release the messenger.
They send messengers down and capture the water right at that depth. Then the students bring the water back up and they subject it to a whole series of tests.
Okay, the pH is 8 and the degrees is 18.2 degrees Celsius.
Once all the data is collected, we then go out and look for some marine mammals and hopefully find some.
Guys, straight ahead, 12 o'clock, guys.
Just off blue whales.
Abominable. Sibling.
And then on the way back into the harbor, once we reach the harbor mouth, the students get a chance to actually analyze the data that they collected. So it's their job to review the video that they took of the fish to see what types of fish they saw there and how many there were. It's their job to use microscopes to look at the plankton sample that they collected to see if they found any fish eggs or fish larvae. And it's their job to look at the water quality data that they collected and see if they can identify any trends.
For our station, we had the water quality, and we collected water samples at various levels.
Another important part of science is for scientists to communicate what they've learned.
Learning from a textbook and in class is one thing, but really going outside and experiencing it for yourself is another. You know, it was a lot of fun getting to go hands-on with water quality samples and plankton and digital fishing.
I just think the most exciting part of this program for me is to see how engaged the students are in science education. And as a science educator, it's just great to see that students can become excited about science and maybe even consider becoming a scientist when they get older.
We have students that are actively involved in today's research. We put them on the forefront of that research and allowed them to be part of protecting their oceans.